derived from Greek and Latin root words spect, meaning look, photo, meaning light, and metri, meaning to measure or count. Spectrophotometry, by its simplest definition, involves quantification of light that is either absorbed, transmitted, reflected, and/or emitted by a sample. Light, or electromagnetic radiation, spans a wide range of wavelengths from gamma rays to radio waves. Based on the region of the electromagnetic spectrum applied, a multitude of chemical characteristics and properties can be probed. In this video, we will focus on the visible and near-infrared, or IR, regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. Visible light is composed of wavelengths between approximately 400 and 800 nanometers, which we visually perceive as hues of purple, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. When white light, or light composed of the entire visible spectrum, is passed through a chemical solution, several processes occur, including absorption and transmission. When light is absorbed by a chemical solution, electromagnetic energy is converted into promoting molecules to their excited states. However, typically not all light is absorbed. The residual light that passes through the solution is defined as the amount of electromagnetic energy transmitted. Visually, we perceive the color of a chemical solution based upon the wavelengths of light which are absorbed versus transmitted. For instance, a red solution is red because all wavelengths except those in the red region of the spectrum are absorbed, while the red wavelengths are transmitted to and detected by our eyes. By definition, transmittance, T, is equal to the ratio of light that passes through a sample, P, to the amount of light that is irradiated onto a sample, P sub O. By measuring the amount of light transmitted, the amount of light absorbed by a solution can be quantified as the relationship is logarithmic. It is important to note that both transmittance and absorbance are unitless values. Instruments which are capable of measuring absorbance and transmittance of light are called spectrophotometers. There are a wide variety of shapes, sizes, and complexities of components, allowing spectrophotometers to analyze many different types of samples. Despite their diversity, all spectrophotometers typically have four major components: a light source, the sample cell, a monochromator, and the detector. The light source irradiates the sample cell. The monochromator disperses the light into finite wavelengths, which are then individually identified and measured by the detector. This allows properties like concentration to be measured. Depending on the instrument setup, the monochromator may be placed before or after the sample cell. To see how this type of measurement occurs, let's take a look inside a visible near IR spectrophotometer used in your lab. The sample to be measured is contained in a cuvette with known dimensions. A tungsten violet LED acts as the light source. Light is irradiated through the sample and focused via a lens and pinhole. The spectrum of light transmitted by the sample is reflected off a mirror into a prism. The prism acts as a monochromator, dispersing the light into individual wavelengths. The dispersed light is reflected off a second mirror onto a linear charge-coupled device, or CCD, detector. The CCD is composed of a series of pixels which detect photons of light. It converts them into measurable electrical signals, distinguishing the amount of each wavelength that was transmitted through the sample. These measurements are converted to absorbance versus wavelength values, which are plotted in the Logger Pro software you will use in lab. In this example, the solution being analyzed is blue. What wavelengths are transmitted? What wavelengths appear in the absorbance spectra? You may wonder what's so important about the absorbance of a chemical solution. Well, a linear relationship exists between absorbance and molar concentration, known as Beer's law. This relationship allows us to interpret valuable information related to chemical concentration. A complete discussion and application of Beer's Law can be seen in the University of Arizona Beer's Law video. Good luck, and thanks for watching.